Hey, good morning. Yes, it is. It is Tuesday, October 22nd. So what are we going to talk about today? We're going to talk about, you know, how soon, you know, we talked about this before in a video, but not really that much in depth. You know, is our line of work at risk, you know, with battery-powered equipment out there? And you'd be surprised at what my answer is. So stay tuned. Alrighty, welcome back. My name is Eric, if you didn't already know it. And yes, this is the weekday, Monday through Friday. Today is Tuesday. It's available on podcast as well for your listening pleasure. So what are we talking about today? I'm talking about, you know, is our job in jeopardy? Is our way of life in jeopardy? And what about the future of small engine repair guys? Are they in jeopardy? And the short answer is no. And the long answer is, no, I can't see it. And why is that? Because a lot of states, governments, federal and state, were trying to push this all on us. And I think you found that they also found a big pushback. And what do I mean by a big pushback? I mean, I'm an average guy, all right? I love my battery-operated DeWalt. You hear me talk about it all the time, you know, for my impacts, my drills, and everything, right? Because they've come a long way with it. They've made it so that it's something that I'm using on a daily basis, and it holds up, right? Now, what did that replace? That replaced the one you plugged in, right? It wasn't a gas powered, it was electric. But we got a battery now, so we're versatile. We can take it all over the place. And now they've got so many things that go with it, you know, that you can have an inverter set up where you use the 20 volt batteries, you can charge your phone, you got, you know, 110, 120 outlet. So they've come a long ways in that, all right? You know, like Hoglewood, New York, if you're not familiar with that, she tried to ban everything but electric. No more wood stoves, no more propane, no more. And are you asinine? You know, that's going to put us back in the dark ages. California can't even keep the lights on because they can't supply enough power to what they've got going on. And they're telling their people with EVs, electric vehicles, please do not plug it in because the grid has been over where it's shutting down. And that's, you know, a lot of times, you know, I scratch my head because it sounds good on paper, right? You get people up in government that have nothing better to do than to mess with our lives. That's how I look at it. They don't have a real job. They think their job is to mess with our lives. And that they have to come up with some new laws, new proposals, new this, new that, to say they're doing their job. But what I find is they don't look at the consequences to their actions. Every action has a reaction, whether it be good or bad, right? So I think, like the electric vehicles, there's a place for them. There is. But not for everybody at this time. You know, if I'm running a gas-powered truck or a diesel-powered truck and my neighbor has got an EV, electric vehicle, am I going to talk down to him because he's got an EV? No, absolutely not. To each your own, right? And hopefully it gets you where you want to go and it's economical for you. Because one of the biggest things you have to get into that market is they're so expensive up front, right? But what they don't tell you is they have a lifespan of about 10 years, the batteries do. And by the time you get to the end of 10 years, the batteries cost more than the car. So where do I think we're at right now? I think that there's millions of gas-powered equipment out there for small engine repair. It's not going anywhere. People are still using them. They're still being sold, all right? And the commercial application, you know, they're going to have to come a long way in technology before the commercial guys can use them, to be honest. Because it's what we're seeing in our area is they decided to have this mandate for the schools that by a certain year, I'm not sure which year it is, but have the whole bus fleet go from gas and diesel to electric. And here's where they're running into problems now, that the buses are actually 10 to 12 foot longer so that they can accommodate the batteries. The buses they're using now, they use them in the morning to pick up the kids. And then they use them at night to take the kids home, right? That's your main run. But what they're finding is that the battery-powered buses, some of them aren't even making the morning run, where it's too big of a loop. And if they are making the loop, they're not ready for the afternoon because they haven't had a chance to get charged back up. And now they're looking at having to put up new buildings to house these buses so that they're not outside in the cold. This is consequences to the action, right, of New York government. Is what you thought was a good idea maybe 10, 15 years down the road if the technology catches up. But why would you throw us into the caveman stage, you know, in this technology? It's not there. Why didn't we go from a gas or diesel powered to a hybrid? What do I mean by hybrid? I mean, it can run on gas or electric or diesel or electric. And just a flick of a switch. So in a lot of this computerized stuff, it can do it on its own. If the batteries are fully charged, the bus is going to run on electric. When it starts getting down, the diesel engine is going to come on board and start charging again. Easy peasy. Or you can at least get to where you want to go and back with the diesel engine that's on board. See, I would consider a hybrid, but not an all electric right now. See, now the military have been using the hybrids for years. And my last Chevy that I had, it had the onboard system of when it sensed I didn't need the power, it would drop back to four cylinder. And if I needed, you know, put the gas pedal down or I need to go a little faster or pass somebody, the eight cylinder, the other four would kick back in again and give me the power. What's wrong with that? Or the hybrid of where you can go so far, and if you're getting low on electric, switch over and run gas or diesel. That makes sense. But how does that relate to the small engine repair world? Well, from what I understand, the zero turns that run off, I think they're 60-volt batteries, you're not going to get very much lawn mowing done, maybe 8 to 10 minutes. So that wouldn't even do a tenth of my yard. Push mowers are the same way. You know, they're not lasting that long to where you got to charge them. So if you're spending 3 or 4 hours a day trying to get a 20-minute yard mowed because you're frigging around with batteries, it's not economical, it's not feasible, and the public is not going to utilize it. You know, I always say, let things go where the market dictates. You know, where the consumer decides they want something. That's, you know, because it's a consumer-driven world, whether you like it or not. That what I decide that I want and I buy is based on how well it's going to hold up. Not to compete with the Joneses or anybody else. It's going to be my likes and dislikes and trying to find a balance in there. So I'm curious to see, to see what you guys think about it. You know, that I don't see it being a factor now. You know, last year I thought it'd be a bigger factor than it actually is. But I think what's taken place in the last year is a lot of stuff that they thought would be farther ahead technology-wise isn't. You know, the best one out there is Elon Musk, all right? He's out there coming up with different things. And he's doing things that the naysayers say can't be done. We need more people like that. He's saying technology just isn't there yet. And then I was listening the other day on the radio, and they're looking into these driverless car crashing in low light fog and sunshine on the sensors or something. That's a long ways off. But, you know, back when I was a kid, we watched the Jetsons, right, where they went back and forth to their little... And I figured we'd be there by now because everything else, Star Trek, flip phones, we got the iPhones, we got a computer in our hand that we can talk to. We have AI that you can ask a question and AI will respond to you. And it's all technology. So why haven't we come up with something better than what we have? And I'm not talking electric, because I don't think electric is the way out. Because if you're trying to get electric, you're doing solar, wind, coal, nuclear to power the grid. The technology does get further advanced. It's coming, right? Just, I don't think sooner than later. I mean, it's just not there yet. Or it is, and it's not being given to us, the public, to use. The military is probably using it. So that kind of brings me to the next thing, is that we always evolve, right? And the idea that you can't teach an old dog new tricks, well, yes, you can, if the old dog is willing to listen and do stuff. And we can do pushbacks when it starts to eventually show up at our shop of saying we're not going to work on it, or we're going to become skilled in that as well. And that there is a time coming where you are going to have to adapt to doing both and then seeing who wins out, right? Because as the technology gets better, we're going to see more of it because the consumer is happy with the product. Right now, the consumer is not happy with what they're getting. You'd be surprised of how many battery-operated push mowers and zero turns are on Facebook Marketplace and on the curbs and yard sales. Because they're just a pain in the ass to use, and they aren't holding up, right? But we're going to have to, maybe not in our lifetime, if you're in your 60s like I am, but the trade is going to change. And the trade that we're in of repairing is going to have to change too, because everything evolves, right? It's always evolving. We're learning new things. You know, the CDI box is on riding lawnmowers, you know, a computerized system. That's new. We're accepting that, right? And we're learning to work on it. The same thing is going to be for the battery powered. Is from what I've seen, and you guys can tell me if I'm wrong, but I'm looking at like these zero turns. You still have lawnmower blades. You still have the chassis. You still have the mower decks to upkeep. You know, the spindles and all that. The only difference is you have a battery that's spinning the engine instead of a combustion like, you know, gas or diesel. But you're still going to have to do service work on that piece of equipment. It's not just, you know, run it until it drops, right? So I think that we need to start looking at that as well for you younger guys that are in the trade, that you probably might want to start researching and taking on some of this battery operated stuff to, you know, your trimmers, you got the chainsaws now that are out there. You're going to have a mindset from carburation to electrical diodes and switches and all that. And that can make you a dual tradesman because now you're being schooled in both, right? And I think it's going to be gradual enough so it gives you time to start tearing these things apart and seeing how they work. And I think that at this point in time, you know, I'm not seeing enough to where it's coming to our shop, but I can see it in the future that we're going to have to evolve. And I think that it's going to be quite a ways out, and it's very lucrative to get into this business still today. If you wanted to start today doing stuff, repairs on gas, it's going to be around for a while. So I'm going to start wrapping this up. What's your take on it? What are you seeing? I mean, I know that the mom and pops are on their way out. I already know that. And the ones of us that are left are few and far between, right? Because the market has changed, you know. Instead of people coming to us for their parts and service work and all that, they're now buying off from eBay, Amazon, and they're watching YouTube videos, and they're trying to fix them themselves. And like we talked about here last week in a video, sometimes when they bring you a box of stuff, they think you should have it. One of you guys said it had, should be cheaper because I've already got it tore all apart for you. No, it's not. No, because it probably was something minor until you tore everything apart. But are you seeing any of it? I haven't seen any of the zero turns of the push mowers yet to get a good look at them. If you have, speak up. On that note, you guys have a great day, a good Tuesday, and we'll catch you here bright and early tomorrow morning. Again, thanks so much for being part of the channel. You know, for you guys that have subscribed, I think we took on 200 in the past week. Thanks so much for subscribing and hitting the like button on the videos. It lets me know and it kind of gauges what do you guys want to hear about and what do you don't want to hear about. Because there's no sense in me talking about stuff that you don't want to hear about, right? Well, you guys have a great Tuesday.